Hey guys, so for number 52, we're going to use properties of logarithms to condense the logarithmic expression, and then we're going to write the expression as a single logarithm whose coefficient is 1. Where possible, we're going to evaluate logarithmic expressions. So first and foremost, we need to know what the properties of logarithms are. If you have them out, feel free to use them and memorize them as best as possible. They're very useful for doing these types of problems. So let's write a little review here as to what they are. So when we are condensing, and I'm going to write here that we're condensing going this way, meaning we're making smaller. When we have subtraction between two logs, that turns into the division of the same log. When we have addition between two logs, that turns into the multiplication of one log. And then when we have a coefficient, something out in front, that turns into the exponent. So I'll draw a little arrow up there to show that that turns into an exponent. Let's keep this up here just so we can review it. So we have 4 log base 6 of 4 plus 1/7 of log base 6 of r minus 8 minus 1/2 of log base 6 of r. Okay, so the first thing I always like to do is check if I have any coefficients to put as exponents. That's my go-to first thing. So all these coefficients that you see here, the 4, the 1/7, and the 1/2 over here, we're going to make those exponents of the log. So we're going to bring those out and put them as exponents of the log. So that's going to give us log base 6 of 4 to the power of 4 plus log base 6 of r minus 8 to the power of 1/7 minus log base 6 to the power of r to the power of 1/2. Now we have 3 logs and we don't have any coefficients for any of them. So let's keep condensing. These first 2 logs are being added to each other and they have the same base of 6. So we can turn that into multiplication of 1 log. So let's write that as log base 6 of 4 to the power of 4 times r minus 8 to the power of 1/7. Okay, and then we still have this. So you can probably tell right here that we can probably evaluate 4 to the power of 4. So let's go ahead and just do that. So now we have 2 logs with the same base, and because they are being subtracted, we can turn that into division of 1 log. So that's going to be log base 6. First one's going to be our numerator, and the second one is going to be our denominator. So that's going to be log base 6 of 256, r times 8 to the power of 1/7, over, all over, r to the power of 1/2. Now we've condensed the logarithmic expression into a single log, and this is the correct answer. Whenever we have exponents in fractions, it's not ideal. It's not like proper math language. So we always should try to write those as radicals instead. So let's rewrite this in its radical form. So that's going to be log base 6 of 256. And then instead of r minus 8 to the power of 1/7, that's going to be 7th root of r minus 8. Remember that the denominator in the exponent will always become the root, and the numerator will become the new exponent. The new exponent is 1, but because it is 1, we don't need to write it. And then in the denominator, r to the 1/2 will turn into the square root of r. Remember, a square root always has a root of 2, but we don't always write it here. So our answer is log base 6 of 256 times the 7th root of r minus 8 over the square root of r.